Hey, it's Medicosis Perfectionist, where medicine makes perfect sense. Let's continue our bleeding and coagulation playlist. Today, we'll compare between hemolytic uremic syndrome and thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura. With that said, now let's get started. Let me answer the question of the previous video. Out of the five stigmata of TTP, which two will help you narrow the differential towards HUS and TTP? And the answer is, the most important two are microangiopathic hemolytic anemia and thrombocytopenia. Only these should make you suspect HUS or TTP. Hemolytic uremic syndrome is divided into atypical HUS and typical HUS. In today's video, we are talking about typical HUS, which is childhood, which has bloody diarrhea. Thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura has inherited type and acquired type. Inherited, it's extremely rare that it is a genetic deficiency of the ADAMTS13 gene, which will lead to deficiency of the ADAMTS13 enzyme. Acquired, there is no deficiency, like the enzyme is there, but there is an inhibitor, usually an IgG inhibitor, of the ADAMTS13 enzyme, leading to decreased activity of ADAMTS13 enzyme, usually less than 10% of normal. By the way, what does ADAMTS13 stand for? It stands for a disintegrin and metalloproteinase with thrombospondin type 1 motif member 13. Screw me. HUS is a triad, but thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura is a pentad. HUS, E. coli 0157H7, we're talking about typical HUS, has a bloody diarrhea because of the E. coli. We have the triad. Number one, microangiopathic hemolytic anemia. Number two, thrombocytopenia. Three, acute renal failure. How about TTP? There is no bloody diarrhea. There is no E. coli 0157H7. And we have five things. One, microangiopathic hemolytic anemia. Two, thrombocytopenia. Three, acute renal failure. These three are the same as here. Four and five are unique. Fever and neurological symptoms. The neurological symptoms are usually altered mental status. Typical HUS, etiology, idiopathic, the most likely cause is the Shiga-like toxin of the enterohemorrhagic E. coli 0157H7 associated with undercooked meat, unpasteurized milk, water, and vegetables. It's raw. Epidemiology, children. This is the typical HUS, by the way. Pathophysiology, the E. coli will produce a Shiga-like toxin. Not Shiga toxin, but Shiga-like toxin, which will lead to endothelial damage and epithelial damage, which will lead to bloody diarrhea. The endothelial damage will lead to platelet activation and microangiopathic hemolytic anemia. Clinically, because the platelets have been consumed, there could be mucocutaneous bleeding. Pallor and fatigue because of the hemolytic anemia. Bloody diarrhea because of the EHEC. Uremic stigmata because of the acute renal failure. Diagnostic results. Platelet count is low. It's called thrombocytopenia, which will lead to prolonged bleeding time. Peripheral smear will show the schistocytes because of the microangiopathic hemolytic anemia. PT and PTT are normal because the secondary hemostasis is fine. RBCs are low because it's anemia. Hemoglobin is low because it's anemia. Hematocrit is low because it's anemia. MCV is normal because it's a normocytic anemia. LDH is high. Haptoglobin is low because it's a hemolytic normocytic anemia. Coombs is negative because it's non-immune. BUN and creatinine are high because of the acute renal failure. Oliguria could be there because of the acute renal failure. Microscopic hematuria and hypertension because of the acute renal failure. Screening for E. coli 0157H7 can help you. Treatment. Supportive, it's a self-limited disease. Please remember this because TTP is an emergency, but HUS is self-limited. Symptomatic uremia, go with dialysis. If there's anemia, RBC transfusion. Do not give platelets. Do not give antibiotics. Two very common mistakes on the exam. Thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura or TTP etiology. Defect in the ADAMTS13 enzyme could be a deficiency or an inhibitor. Epidemiology, usually young adult, not a child, but a young adult in their 30s. Pathophysiology, there is no cleaving of the ultra-large von Willebrand factor multimers, which will lead to precipitation and accumulation of the von Willebrand factor multimers, which will lead to platelet microthrombi formation. Clinically, mucocutaneous bleeding because the platelets have been consumed. It's called thrombocytopenia. Pallor and fatigue, fever, and altered mental status. These are unique for TTP. Platelet count is low. Bleeding time is prolonged. All of these are the same. However, you add a high temperature, usually a low-grade fever, and ADAMTS13 enzyme activity less than 10% of that of normal. Please remember that CTP is a freaking emergency treatment. Plasmapheresis, PECS, plasma exchange. You take the patient's plasma and give them a normal plasma that contains the ADAMTS13 enzyme. You do the plasmapheresis with fresh frozen plasma or cryosupernatant. No response to plasma exchange. You can give steroids and rituximab, dialysis if there is acute renal failure. Again, do not give platelets, do not give antibiotics. Let's compare between typical HUS and TTP. Typical HUS, it's a triad, but TTP is a pentad. Don't forget the fever and neurological symptoms. Idiopathic and idiopathic. The most likely cause is the Shiga-like toxin of the E. coli 0157H7. The most likely cause is defect in LMTS13. Typical patients are children here, young adults here. Schistocytes are found in both. Lab results are very similar in either, but remember, blood in the stool is found only in typical HUS. Screening for the E. coli 0157H7 is only useful for typical HUS. How about TTP? The temperature is high, and this is unique for TTP. LMTS13 enzyme activity is low, and this is unique to TTP. Also, the acute mental status changes, this is unique for TTP. Cool. Treatment. Here it's self-limited, but here is a freaking emergency. Big difference. In HUS, supportive care, symptomatic uremia, go with dialysis, anemia, you give red blood cells, do not give platelets, do not give antibiotics. How about TTP? It's an emergency. Plasmapheresis with plasma exchange. If the hemoglobin is low and like there is anemia, give red blood cells. Do not give platelets, do not give antibiotics. What if the patient did not respond to the plasma exchange? You can try steroids and rituximab. Let's review. HUS in a nutshell. It's a triangle. It's a triad of microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, thrombocytopenia, and acute renal failure. Remember the bloody diarrhea because of the E. coli. TTP is a pentad, a pentagon. But please note, there is no bloody diarrhea in TTP. What are the five symptoms? Okay, microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, thrombocytopenia, acute renal failure. Same three. And then you add two. Fever and neurological symptoms, usually altered mental status. By the way, you don't have to wait until you find five stigmata in the patient before you make the diagnosis. If you find microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, thrombocytopenia, fever, and some up, you have your diagnosis. Oh, but there is no acute renal failure yet. Shut up, it doesn't matter. Let's review from scratch. HUS was a triangle. What are the three symptoms? Microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, thrombocytopenia, renal failure. TTP is a pentagon. 1, 2, 3, 4, yes. This is a pentagon. Microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, thrombocytopenia, acute renal failure, fever, and neurological symptoms. Let's go to picmonic baby. HUS, hemolytic uremic syndrome. You have a triad of microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, thrombocytopenia, and acute renal failure. Remember, there is acute bloody diarrhea, there is injury of the endothelium and blood in the stool. There are schistocytes or helmet cells, and LDH is high, but haptoglobin is low. Treatment is supportive care. If there is kidney failure, you dial the dialysis. On the other hand, TTP is a pentad. We have microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, thrombocytopenia, renal failure, neurological symptoms, and the fever beaver. We have microthrombi. There is a problem with ADAMTS13. Treatment is plasmapheresis and glucocorticoids, which is a quarter on steroids. Go to picmonic.com/VIP hookup/medicosis. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, hit the bell, and click on the join button. You can support me here or here. Go to Picmonic, and you can go to my website. Thank you for watching. As always, be safe, stay happy, and study hard. This is Medicosis Perfectionados, where medicine makes perfect sense.